With a delay and an extended season, Destiny 2 Beyond Light has finally landed on our hard drives. After sinking an entire week into it, I think it's finally time for me to give my thoughts. Now, before we really dive into the video, be warned that I'll be discussing spoilers regarding the campaign. The footage you're also about to see will contain spoilers as well. If you haven't played or beaten the Beyond Light campaign and want to avoid spoilers, I understand. Thank you for clicking on the video anyway, and remember, if you want to come chat about Destiny, I stream every Thursday at 6 PM Eastern over on Twitch. The link for that will be in the description down below. Alright, so when Beyond Light was announced, it promised some big things. Talking strictly narratively, we as Guardians were going to finally visit the icy moon of Europa, reconnect with the Stranger, and learn to wield the darkness, and begin what would be the next arc of the Destiny saga. Let me tell you, it does not disappoint. The moment you sign in, the game will direct you with a few cutscenes that set the tone and the stage for the expansion, and then throws you right into the story. It does all this without giving you a chance to look at the season pass, or go to the tower, or any other playlist. Now, of course, once the cutscenes are over, you can leave Europa and do that, but I think the fact that it throws you into the action right from the get-go is such a strong point. I highly recommend doing the first mission through its entirety before diving into anything else. So you start up and are tasked with following a distress call made by everyone's favorite Elixni, Varix. You head off into the icy wastes and encounter the new fallen house, House Salvation. You're then treated to a cutscene of the new villain, Aramis, the Kel of House Salvation, royally schooling Varix. You swoop in and save him, then after a little exposition, the world opens up. From the moment I started the game, I was instantly locked in. The new title screen, the new character screen, the UI changes, and the music are all just captivating. The new dark color palette invokes a hint of nostalgia for D1 veterans like myself. Unlike previous expansions, Beyond Light doesn't have you leaving Europa too often. There's one mission that sees you heading to the returning Cosmodrome to meet the new light vendor, Shaw Han, but other than that, you'll spend all your time in Europa learning how to wield stasis and hunting Aramis and her lieutenants. With that, I want to touch on stasis real quick. I've mainly been playing the new Titan class, the Behemoth, and let me say, it took a bit to figure out. Shout out to Zeph for explaining it to me. But once I got the hang of it, it became the most satisfying super to use. Now I know the PvP balancing for stasis is a bit wonky, but in PvE, it's fun, and even without any aspects or fragments, it's incredibly rewarding to land those wombo combos of grenade and melee chains. Another thing I think Bungie deserves credit for is how they present stasis to you. You don't receive stasis right away. Far from it, in fact. Once you meet up with the Stranger and her makeshift fire team, comprising of the Drifter and Eris Morn, you begin getting missions that lead you to a breadcrumb trail that rewards you with just a taste of stasis. And honestly, I think this is a great design choice. It leaves you longing for more, and is a secondary driving force to keep playing besides just hunting the new villains. Narratively, they also don't hold back on constantly reminding you of the weight of wielding darkness. As you progress through the main narrative and beyond, Ghost will often make remarks or comments about how he can't help you. When you wield the darkness, you are on your own. He is tied strictly to the Traveler and the Light, but he'll also remind you that no matter what, he will be by your side, whether you continue to wield stasis in the darkness or not. And at one point, Zavala even makes an appearance on Europa to discuss his reservations with you proceeding the way that you are. So you continue your journey, you finally unlock stasis, you confront Aramis in a final fight that feels earned and rewarding, and that's it. Right? No, it's not. And that's the best part. Along the campaign, you'll have quests to unlock chests with stasis. Now, each chest can only be unlocked after you've progressed in learning to control stasis, and in turn, you will receive a piece of the Christocrine armor, That's the armor that you've seen in all the promotional trailers that looks like big fur coats and snowshoes and things like that. You'll get a few pieces during the campaign, but you must continue the narrative post-campaign to finish the set. Here lies another strong point for the expansion. It's world building. Throughout the course of the campaign, you will slowly attack at Aramis's forces, all the while learning stasis, taking down lieutenants, and discovering the secrets of Europa. These lieutenant fights act as boss fights that showcase the different stasis supers. One of them will wield the power of the behemoth, another will wield the power of the revenant, and the third will wield the power of the shadebinder. They're epic and challenging, and they have their own mechanics, and they help flesh out the new House of Fallen in this new post-pyramid world. Now, like I said, Europa is home to many secrets. However, you're not equipped or able to find them right off the bat. And that's because Beyond Light can be hard. With the new power cap increase comes the grind of getting new gear and raising your power level and becoming stronger. You're at a disadvantage when you first land on Europa. You will constantly be replacing your old legendaries and exotics with blues and new legendaries. I think during my time in the main storyline, I was only able to really do one lost sector, because some of the zones and enemies were labeled as question marks or skulls. This drives that feeling of isolation and survival. Unless you decide to go off and do other things on Nessus or the EDZ, or you decide to just cash your pinnacles in right up front with Vanguard Strikes, Crucible, or Gambit, you are going to be up against a stronger foe, and you will need to fight your way through it all. Now, post-campaign, Varric sets you up on the Empire Hunts, which are, what I can gather, weekly little missions that lead into these bigger fights. These push this Fallen and Vanguard narrative to help you establish a foothold on Europa, all the while making sure no one takes Aramis's place. Then, the Stranger has quests post-campaign that help you earn aspects and fragments, which are used to customize your new Stasis subclass. All of this is available right now, and at the time of writing this script and recording this video, the actual seasonal content hasn't come out yet, and neither has the raid. So right now, launch week is already packed with stuff you can do. Besides all the quests that you get on Europa, you also have the Cosmodrome to explore. You have the new strike on the Cosmodrome, the Disgraced. You have Strike playlist, you have Crucible playlist, you have your Gambit playlist, and there's just more of it to come. There was a thought that floated in my head from the moment I started this expansion. Beyond Light was supposedly going to be Destiny 3, and honestly, it shows in the best of ways. The sweeping UI and system changes breathe a new life into mundane things like your character screen or the Triumphs tab. Europa has this giant sense of discovery and adventure with each new lost sector you find, gold chest you find, little breadcrumb of lore that you unlock. The initial narrative threads that are being set up with Beyond Light are great. And the expansion also continues existing threads that we have been waiting to have answers to for years. And all of it is just stoking the fire of hope within me. I was hyped when Beyond Light was announced, and now I'm even more excited as a veteran to see where Bungie really takes Destiny. Now, if you're iffy about coming back to Destiny, I can proudly say now's a great time to dive back in. There's a new player experience. If you're a returning veteran and you just need to pick up Beyond Light, you'll have plenty to do the moment you touch down on Europa. Now, yes, I know there are things that are concerning people, like PvP balancing and the loot pool and how sunsetting affected the loot you can earn world drop style, but I think these are minor when compared to the grand scheme of the expansion. Like I mentioned earlier, this is launch week. We still have a whole breadth of seasonal content that we haven't even gotten to touch yet. Not to mention, we have the seasonal events like the Dawning. We have the Hawkmoon quest that is coming within the season. We have so much more down the pipeline. And while there are the concerns that people have overall, Beyond Light is a great time to be a Destiny fan. With all that being said, if you want to discuss any of this, I do stream live on Twitch, again, as I mentioned earlier in the video, but also please feel free to leave a comment down below. I love hopping into the comments and talking with you guys. If you did enjoy the video, please make sure to give the video a like, and if you want more Destiny content like this, be sure to hit the subscribe button and ding the notification bell. As always, don't forget to lift, feast, end game, and I'll see you in the next one.